Good evening. Presidents are not kings, but in at least one respect, they enjoy the privilege of royalty. Under the Constitution, a president's authority to pardon people for federal offenses or grant clemency in such cases is, depending on which legal scholar you ask, either absolute or very nearly so. So today, when the president issued yet another pardon, few, if any, questioned his power to do it. But there are questions about his judgment and intent, especially whether he's using this and other pardons to send a message to anyone contemplating a plea deal in the Russia investigation. Hang tough, keep quiet, I'll take care of you would be the message. Dinesh D'Souza, who he pardoned today, is a right-wing author and filmmaker who pleaded guilty to campaign finance violations. He's also an Obama and Clinton hater and the author of tweets like these. A photo of President Obama reading, "You can take the boy out of the ghetto." D'Souza has also written that slavery was not a racist institution and supports President Trump's conspiracy theory about a spy in his campaign. The president pardoned him today. He also said he's thinking about commuting the sentence of former Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich, a Democrat who, among his other corrupt acts, tried to sell President Obama's vacated Senate seat. Additionally, the president says he's considering a pardon for Martha Stewart, convicted of lying to federal investigators. So in those three, you've got public corruption, campaign cash violations, and lying to the feds. Now, keep it honest, those are the same or similar charges that members of Team Trump either are or could be facing. But those aren't the only through lines and interesting patterns in this pardon puzzle. There's also the appearance of presidential payback. Both Blagojevich and Stewart have ties to fired FBI Director James Comey, who, you might have heard, the president isn't too fond of. Now, Comey was the U.S. attorney who prosecuted Stewart. Former U.S. attorney Patrick Fitzgerald, who prosecuted Blagojevich, is a Comey friend and currently a member of his legal team. He also investigated the Valerie Plame leak, which led to the conviction of Scooter Libby for lying to the FBI. As you know, the president pardoned Libby last month. So is contemplation of a pardon for Martha Stewart a shot at Comey's legacy? Maybe. But there are other connections to contemplate as well. Dinesh D'Souza was prosecuted by Preet Bharara, who President Trump fired and is currently working as a CNN legal analyst. He and Comey are critics of the president. So was the D'Souza pardon done to zing Bharara? Again, possibly. But there are still other connections to contemplate. And this one starts with reality and ends with show. Both the former governor and the lifestyle guru appeared on the president's former reality show, The Apprentice, which Citizen Trump once plugged on her program.
So, Donald, how's your new apprentice? Is it going to be like...
I think it's going to be great.
Yeah?
I mean, it's on Thursday night, and it's really going to be... I think it's the best we've done thus far.
Well, there are other points of commonality in the pardons, potential pardons and clemency, the language used to justify them. Each, the president says, was treated unfairly or harshly unfairly or unbelievably unfairly, which is also the kind of language he uses to describe his own treatment by the Mueller probe.